Now, you define P1 equal to 1 over P1, P2 equal to 1 over P2, and P3 equal to 1 over P3. So these small p's, they are also positive quantities. And now you put this here. So what do we get? So we get that y1 by p1 plus y2 by p2 plus y3 by p3 is greater than equal to 1 over p1 to the y1, p2 to the y2, p3 to the y3. Or p1 to the y1, p2 to the y2, p3 to the y3 is written 1 over y1 by so this is the given treatment. This is the so that finishes it, that we can also show the geometric is also greater than the harmonic. For example, if you take two numbers, say 1 and 2. So in these, the arithmetic mean is 1.5, the geometric mean is 1.4, 1.4, the harmonic mean is 1.6. Take any two or three numbers and check. If you like to play with it, you can play. But you will always find that this is the problem. So that's another part of it, and this is a very interesting result. Almost in the 80s. It was done by P.T. Landsberg. He has several books on thermodynamics. He once came to Calcutta also. I had the fortune to be present in one of his lectures at IACS. He did this work in around 1979 or 80 or 81. So this proof that from thermodynamics you can get the relation that arithmetic mean is better from geometric mean by using the second method. So probably that finishes today's lecture. So they are very happy now. The lecture is finished. But now, so if you have any question, you can always ask. Or otherwise, I shall take the impression that you have understood everything. I shall be very happy. They will be, your teachers will also be very happy. But don't be afraid of teachers now. So if you have anything to ask, please ask.
Sir, we were starting this book in told that you were going to talk about entropy, but what
confusion is it? So, this is entropy. This is not entropy. And this whole proof is based on this. You calculate the entropy change, we use the part of the second law, both the parts. The first part is the definition of entropy, the second part, the inequality. We use both the parts of the second law and used only entropy.
Yeah, we have using those two things, we have came to a known definition of mathematics, but how do we realize the meaning of entropy or something from this?
This is not about the meaning of it. Within thermodynamics, you cannot have really the meaning. For the meaning of thermodynamics, you have another branch, statistical thermodynamics. You have to go over to that.
to get a meaning of each and every thermodynamic properties, you have to use a model. But in thermodynamics, it is so abstract, you cannot really get the meaning. Say, entropy is disorder. Suppose, this is one statement. So this is very favorite statement among the students. Now, if I say that temperature is also a measure of disorder, so where am I going wrong? Because we have learnt in kinetic theory that temperature is also a measure of disorder. Temperature measures the translation of kinetic energy, so naturally that measures the disorder. If the kinetic energy is very low, tending to zero, so it will be at rest, isn't it? So now let us discuss on this point, that why do we highlight entropy is a measure of disorder, while we already learned that temperature is also a measure of disorder. So why is this needed, this entropy? Both measures, they measure disorder. But there is at least one point where temperature fails to recognize this disorderliness. That is the case of phase transition. Whenever there is a phase transition, the temperature remains constant, but the entropy increases. Say, in going from liquid to vapor state and so on. So that is, well, that is not quite physical in the sense of disorderliness as we think of. It's not a kinetic interpretation. But there probably you can get some sense of it. But otherwise, for any of these thermodynamic quantities, say for example, what is internal energy? You do not have any meaning for that. You can measure the changes from one state to another. You can use it effectively in certain problems. This much, thermodynamics finished. But there lies also the generality of thermodynamics. That you need not consider in model. It is applicable to solid, liquid, gas, nanoparticles, whatever you consider. So whenever there is a system, there is a surroundings, you can define a system. Of course, by a system we do not mean a one or two or four particles. We mean really a number of particles of the order of Avogadro number of particles. But here, thermodynamics always plays its nice role. It is always valid. Okay. So suppose you work with shaker, the equilibrium experiments. You have shaker in your laboratories?
Actually,
use for one. So normally there is a shaker. Actually some of them were happy that the class is finished, but then some unhappy questions have come. Okay. So suppose this is electrically connected shaker. This is shaker means something like this. Okay? So bottles are kept there and the electrical switch is put on and then it shakes. So the bottles for equilibrium experiments, in first year probably the experiment is not there, but it starts from second year at least. So suppose you have a shaker and suppose you have, say, four particles. Two kinds of particles. These two are identical, these two are identical, these two are different. So suppose you have four particles on a shaker and you started shaking it. So there will be mixing. And after some time, you will find that the four particles randomly placed. But then again, if you look carefully at it, after say 15 minutes or half an hour, or if some of you were lucky After 2 minutes you will find that